Welcome to a video on the graph of sine and cosine in the given form. So the goals of the video are to graph the sine and cosine functions with the four basic transformations. We'll state the amplitude, period, phase shift, and vertical shift. So first let's review. The absolute value of A is the amplitude. 2 pi divided by B is the period. C is the vertical translation. If C is positive, it's translated up C units. If C is negative, the function is translated down C units. D is the horizontal translation. If D is greater than 0, the function is translated right. So if we have x minus D, it's translated right. And if D is less than 0, or if we have plus D, it's translated D units to the left. Let's go and take a look at a couple examples. The first thing we should notice is our amplitude is equal to 2. Our period is 2 pi divided by b. 2 pi divided by 2. Our period is pi radians. Notice we have plus pi over 4, so the horizontal shift would be left pi over 4 units. And next, the vertical shift, c is minus 1, so it's going to be down 1 unit. So since we have a lot of transformations here, we're going to take one at a time and set up our coordinate plane to make a nice graph. Now remember, we typically graph sine on the interval from 0 to pi over 2 because that's one period for one complete cycle of the sine curve. But now, notice the period is pi radians. So we're going to have one complete cycle of the sine function in the length of pi radians, but it's shifted left pi over 4 units. So now we'll start the graph of our function instead of at 0 radians, negative pi over 4 radians due to the shift, and then we'll go out pi radians. Well, negative pi over 4 plus pi would equal 3 pi over 4. So on this interval, we'll have one complete cycle of the sine function before it starts to repeat itself again. Now we'll go ahead and divide this into four equal parts. Pi over 4 is in the middle, pi over 2 here, and we have 0 radians here. So far we've taken care of the period and we've taken care of the horizontal shift. Next, the center of the graph is usually the x-axis, but since it's shifted down 1 unit, we're going to use y equals negative 1 as the center of this graph. So now we're ready to go. We have to keep in mind we have an amplitude of 2, but let's go ahead and take a look at the pattern of the basic sine function. Typically we start graphing the sine here at the center line, and we'll do the same, but because of the shift, our first point on this graph will be here on the center line at negative pi over 4. If we know the next fourth for sine is a maximum, since the amplitude is equal to 2, it's going to be 2 units up from the center line at the first fourth, so y will be equal to 1. The next fourth is back at the center line, so we're back here. The third fourth is a minimum of negative 1, but because the amplitude is equal to 2, we'll be down 2 units from the center line, or negative 3, and back up to the center line on this interval, which is equal to the period. So now we can graph this function. And if we wanted to continue this, we would just copy and paste this over additional intervals of pi radians. Let's go and take a look at this one on the graph. I've already set up our window from negative pi over 2 radians to 2 pi radians, scaling by pi over 2 radians. Y min negative 4, y max 3. What we're going to see is sine graph with a thin line and our function graph in a bold line. So there's the basic sine function, and here is our transformed function. Now, of course, we're graphing on a larger interval here, but you can see on our interval from negative pi over 4 to 3 pi over 4, our graph is correct. Let's take a look at another. Okay, the first thing I notice on this one is it's not exactly in the correct form. We have to factor out the coefficient of the x term to fit this form. The first thing I notice on this problem is that it's not in this exact form. We need to factor out the coefficient of the x term to match this. So let's go ahead and do that. So I factor out the 1/2, I'll have x minus, factoring out a half from pi over 4 would be pi over 2. Let's check this. 1/2 times pi over 2 would be pi over 4. Now it's in the correct form. amplitude is equal to a, or 1/2. The period, 2 pi divided by 1/2, the same as multiplying by 2, that'll be 4 pi. The horizontal shift, if we see minus pi over 2, it's going to be right pi over 2 units. And the vertical shift, c is plus 2, so it's going to be up 2 units. Okay, so let's set this up. Let's first talk about the period and the horizontal shift. The period is 4 pi radians. We typically graph the cosine function from 0 to 2 pi. But because it's shifted right pi over 2 units, we'll start our graph here at pi over 2. Now, because the period is 4 pi radians, pi over 2 plus 4 pi is 9 pi over 2. So we'll stop our graph here. Next, we'll divide this into 4 equal parts, as we typically do. There's the half. We'll divide each of these in half. So we'll start our graph here, and we'll finish it here. Next, the vertical shift is up 2 units. So instead of using the x-axis as our center, we'll use y equals 2. Okay, so we have our fourths. We have where we're going to start. We have where we're going to finish. Our amplitude is 1/2. We'll take this into consideration when we plot our key 5 points. So again, we normally start the cosine function at a maximum. We will do the same, but because the amplitude is 1/2, this point will be 1/2 units above the center of this graph. So here's our center, so we'll start up a half unit at 2.5. The next fourth is at the center of the graph, so back here at 2. Next fourth is the minimum. Well, the minimum will be 1/2 unit below this center line, so we'll be at 1.5. Again, 1/2 because the amplitude is 1/2. The next fourth is at the center line, and the last key point is at a maximum again, which was 2.5. We have more than enough information to make a nice graph, look something like this, and of course we could copy and paste this over intervals of 4 pi radians to make a longer graph if we needed. Let's check this one on the calculator as well. Now before we graph this, we do have to change our window. We're going to have to go out to at least 9/2 pi. Let's go out to 5 pi. Our y minimum, y maximum, we can change these slightly. Let's change the y minimum to -1, and then we'll press graph. There's the basic cosine function, and here's our transform function. And again, it looks pretty good compared to what we've done by hand. Let's go ahead and try one more. This is in a slightly different form. Notice that the value of c is in the front, but that's okay. It's not going to change anything. Here's our form. C is equal to 4, so we have a vertical shift of up 4 units. The horizontal shift, if we see plus 1, that's going to be left 1 unit. Now the period is 2 pi divided by b. Our b is actually pi. Well, 2 pi divided by pi is 2 units. So the period is not in terms of pi this time, it's just 2 units. Our amplitude is the absolute value of this coefficient. It's equal to 1. However, notice that a is equal to -1. That's going to cause a reflection across the horizontal axis. So we'll have to be careful on that one. Okay, let's go ahead and set up our axes. Typically, we graph sine on the interval from 0 to 2 pi, but now we'll graph it on the interval from 0 to 2. But since the shift is left 1 unit, we'll sketch the sine function on the interval from -1 to +1. Notice our period is still going to be 2, but because we're shifting it left, units will start at -1. Divide this into fourths. We have a vertical shift up 4 units, so we're going to use 4 as our center of the graph. So we're going to have one complete cycle of the sine function on this interval here, with this being our center. So typically we start the sine function at the center, and we'll do that again, but now our center is going to be here at -1. The next fourth would be a maximum. However, since we have a reflection across the center line, it'll be a minimum, and we'll be down 1 unit from here instead. Then back to the center, and then the third fourth is usually a minimum, but since we have a reflection across the center line, it'll be our maximum here at 5, and then back to the center. It'll look something like that. I hope you found this video helpful. Thank you for watching.